Magnificent Morocco. It's the best wrestlers in the World Wrestling Federation, exclusively on Prism, and it's coming up next, so stay tuned. It's time for Spectrum Wrestling.
Well, good evening, everybody. Very happy hello to you. It's time for the spectacular wrestling. Of course, everybody's been waiting for it since last month. Little Monsoon, yours truly, Dick Graham aboard, and I'll tell you, many, many thousands of folks jamming the Spectrum for our wrestling card. I tell you, it's a biggie today.
And, rightly so, the World Wrestling Federation bringing you the best in championship wrestling. And what an outstanding card here tonight. I can't wait for the excitement, so let's do it.
I'll tell you what to do. Let's go into the ring because the first match is about ready to get underway. We'll talk further about tonight's card as we go along.
Matches are sanctioned and supervised by the Pennsylvania State Athletic Commission. J.J. Pins is the commissioner. Francis Walker is the executive director. Chief deputy in attendance this evening is Arthur Comis. The attending physician is Dr. W.L. Davidson. Timekeeper at the bell, J.P. Mina. Referees assigned by the State Athletic Commission, Dick Worley, Joe Morella. In the ring, Barney Solomon, and I'm your ring announcer for All-Star Wrestling, Gary Michael Capetta. Now, wrestling fans, this is the first event. It is set for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing to my right, from Santo Domingo, he weighs 245 pounds, Israel Matia. New York, 233 pounds, the fiery King Sanchez.
All right, Gorilla Monsoon, you've heard the introductions, as we have, and we've got a pretty much of a mismatch as far as weight concerned here. What do you think?
Well, I think Pete will make up for that with experience, speed, and agility, I'm sure, Dick, because Israel Matia look for a standing ovation here from the enormous crowd here at the Spectrum, but he didn't get it, did he?
He got another kind of a welcome.
Of course, Gary Capetta got his usual welcome as well.
For sure. Okay, we got the third man to square a circle. That's Barney Solomon. Sanchez pointing to Solomon, to Matia.
He's complaining about all the tape that he's got on his wrist, which could be used as
Matia's pretending he's got a bad wrist there. He's showing Solomon.
He's got a bad attitude, too, that can go along with a bad wrist.
We'll find that out before long. All right, apparently the discussion over. The bell rings, and the two participants circling one another, making contact, working and shoving for the time being. A tremendous card on Spectrum Wrestling. Whoa! Talk about that bad wrist. That's not going to help it any.
I'm sure if we got a look at Sanchez's knee underneath that knee pad, you'd find some tape too. Pete's been bothered now for about 6 weeks with a torn ligament on the inside of his right knee. And it's really a tough injury that just sort of nags at you all the time. Sometimes better to break a bone, Dick, than to have a ligament tear, because it really can tear you up for a long time.
All right, Sanchez, minus going back a couple of years now, minus some of the weight that he used to carry, and of course has added to his agility, as you just saw with Matia.
Well, Sanchez, the ring veteran, doesn't have to take a back seat back. Put him in there with anyone if he'd hold his own.
Oh, pretty much the same maneuver, and grabbing the tights too is Matia, away from Barney Solomon. Matia's very shrewd, looking over his shoulder to see where Solomon is. Sanchez gives him a shot to the head there to kind of break the hold, more or less.
He was looking for the referee, and he forgot to look out for that right hand and got to him in a hurry.
Sure did. Well, there's a kick to the back of a leg and a crushing blow, bringing all that weight down on the inside of the knee of Sanchez.
Once again, Dick, Spectrum loaded with signs for the Superfly.
Well, they're here to see him tonight for sure.
Well, this is another golden opportunity for him. This is another title defense tonight by Morocco. The Intercontinental belt is at stake again, once again. And special guest referee for that bout, Chief Jay Strongbow.
Well, he brooks no nonsense when he's in there as a referee or a wrestler. So these guys have to watch themselves. Stud, or rather, Morocco and Crooker. We have Stud. I was thinking about his name a little while ago. He's coming along before very soon. And we're featuring the Invaders later on tonight. Pat Patterson with us. Iron Mike Sharp. We've got a tremendous card, as usual. Peter Santana, always a crowd pleaser tonight. Reed Hansen.
I think this would be a fitting place, Dick, for the Intercontinental title to change hands.
Could be.
One of the greatest sports arenas in the entire world, not only the East Coast or the United States, but the entire world.
Well, you know, Philadelphia is such a great sports city, but it usually gets put down to a great degree by other areas, other New York, maybe so forth, not to put them down, but Philadelphia is a sports city anymore. We've come along a long way in this area. The fans really are very knowledgeable, too. Well, talking about Morocco, talking to him down near the dressing room earlier before the wrestling, he seems rather relaxed. He made no comment about the upcoming match with Snuka, but he was very cool, wasn't he? Very relaxed. 8 days off of wrestling may have done it for him. And Sanchez grabbing a hunk of beard there. Got just a little bit of beard on Mattia. A little bit more. The side headlock to go.
Definitely an illegal maneuver.
Barney Sollerin smacked the arm of Sanchez.
Sanchez all business. Determination, concentration.
Oh! Just on the short end now, taking a blow to the head.
Doesn't seem to be anything wrong with that wrist now, does it?
Not at all, does it? That was not so much a fist on that one, but sort of a karate chop. Yeah.
That reverse chin lock here. Easily turned into a chokehold.
Well, Solomon's very careful about it. He's still watching, feeling underneath there to make sure. Sanchez's wind is not cut off. Sergeant Slaughter returns tonight in the big one tonight against who else but the champion, Bob Backlund. That'll be a bloodletting whenever we saw one. We expected.
Well, the Sarge has all the tools necessary to take the title from anyone on any given night.
It really does. I'll tell you, you know, they kid him about Gomer and all that, the signs from the ringsiders, but he's a very determined man. Backlund will maybe find that out tonight. Sanchez getting upset, huh? Well, all right, the fans rising this too. And a bailout by Mattia. Smashed his head against the ring post. Sanchez cares not that he's on the apron outside. He's gone for him. That's bringing it right back inside the ring.
That's a hard way to come in.
Sure is. All that weight to down his own back. Coming our way against the room. Whoa! Chop to the midsection. Down along the knees goes Israel Mattia.
Open that fist up, please.
He must have did something off that reverse chin lock that upset Peter pretty much, because Pete got bent out of shape in a hurry there, Dick.
Pretty much of a cool customer. He doesn't get up that kind of upset unless something really doesn't win.
Nice flying mare.
Oh,
that'll give you a negative attitude right there.
Well, I said earlier when we first started watching this match, there's a disparity in the weight, but I think you were right. Pete Sanchez's been around a while, and he knows all the holds, and a nice bridge by Mattia. Now it's no longer a bridge. It collapsed on him with the help of Sanchez's foot.
There's a match tonight, Dick, that I'm extremely interested in, and that's the one with the animal, George the Animal Steel against the Polish Power. What a confrontation that's going to be.
Well,
we might have to batten down everything, the tables, the monitors, everything here tonight.
We may get ready to run, maybe.
Well, you never know what the animal's going to do when he comes out here.
True.
the most unorthodox man in professional sports today.
And we have seen Putski really, you know, on a tear.
Oh, he's got a short fuse, too.
He's good-natured as can be, Putski. Everybody knows that. Boy, all of a sudden. Well, Mattia had the break because Sanchez draped over the second rope and still on the ropes. Break it again. Mattia, must say, backed off nicely. Then he's going at Sanchez again. Barney Solomon, third man in the ring.
Oh! Caught him on the side with that knee lift.
Sure did. Sanchez saw him coming, couldn't bail out. He saw that weight coming. He must be stunned.
Uh-huh. Israel's going to teach Barney how to count.
He says, let's have a faster count here, Mr. Referee. Well, you see that from time to time. We saw it a couple of times last month, too. Side headlock. On the ropes somewhere. And whoo!
All right, raked his eyes right along the ring rope.
That is murder. Well, as you said earlier, that was a punch with the first for the right hand. Doesn't seem to be bothering Mattia very much. Baiting the crowd, huh? They respond. Sanchez, meanwhile, has a little opportunity to get his act together, maybe. Clear the cobwebs. But here come the cobwebs again. Mattia, rather relentless. Whoa! All right!
Nice block, by Pete.
Did block. There's a
nice drop kick.
Caught him on the shoulder.
Sunset flip. He's got him.
Oh, maybe, maybe.
He hooked the legs. He got him.
All right! Just caught him. Just caught him. There was a fraction of a second when Mattia almost bailed out of that. Brooke the hold at the count of three, but there it is. Let's get the announcement from Gary Capetta.
Wrestling fans, the time of the match, 8 minutes, 19 seconds. Your winner, Pete Sanchez.
All right, Solomon's still discussing matters with Mattia.
Well, if he hadn't caught him with that sunset flip, there would have been a question of time. He would have caught him with something. The experience was just too much different.
Yep. Well, all right. Let's watch the replay now as we check it out. There's that drop kick. Caught the shoulder of Mattia. Down he went. Sanchez off the rope. Sonny, let's flip up. Sonny, here he comes. Control.
There's nothing like a good story, and all the better if the story's true. In August, Prism's got a whole collection of films based on fact. From the Oscar-winning Chariots of Fire and Mommy Dearest, to the gripping drama of a turncoat New York policeman, Prince of the City, and the behind-the-scenes story of Screen Comics' Abbott and Costello. Great stories, and they're all true. Watch for them in August on Prism. Direct from Las Vegas, it's Lola Falana in a concert so entertaining the crowds are dancing in the aisle. Lola Falana, First Lady of Vegas. You're watching Prism, the best in sports, movies, and entertainment specials.
There we go. The fans getting cranked up because getting ready for match number two in our long program.
The Samurai Warrior is entering the ring.
You're not neutral about him. And the crowd rising to the occasion. The Samurai Warrior getting ready to meet Mexico. Let's go to ring announcer Mel Fuller.
For one call with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first in the corner to my right,
hailing from Osaka, Japan, weighing in at 247 pounds, the samurai warrior, Mr. Fuji. And his opponent, hailing from Toluca, Mexico, weighing in at 244 pounds, Tito Santana.
Big crowd favorite, Tito Santana. He'll have his hands full tonight with the Devious One.
Oh, hey, he's got that samurai sword on sheath, and that's nothing to fool with. But he sheaths it again and hands it to an attendant. So I guess that was only a warning, sort of symbolic of what's going to come tonight. And these two guys clash.
Fuji wouldn't surprise me with anything he does in there.
Sure.
We're going to go through a salt ceremony now with about 3/4 of a pound of salt, most of which won't be used in the ceremony. Look at Tito eyeing him, never taking his eyes off him for a second.
All right, some more of the salt goes back in the belt line there. All right, the preliminary is over. Now Tito Santana, Mr. Fuji eyeing one another. All right, the crowd sensing that something of foreign extraction is in the right hand, the closed fist, Mr. Fuji. Now under the left armpit.
Fuji mask. The referee could check him all night. He'd never find anything.
That's right. Yet. Interesting name, the young referee here, Morella. Uh-huh.
Okay. Sounds very familiar,
yeah,
doesn't it?
Yeah. All right, the referee checking, very alert on both sides here. Give each guy an equal shake. But now it's all over. Santana making contact now with Fuji. Oh, blocks the punch. Gives one himself. Another. And still another. Whoa!
Nice shoulder block by Santana.
Comes the body slam, baby. Woo. Body shoulder block down again.
Oh, beautiful drop kick. Oh, he walked right out of that.
That came right down to the back of his head. Woo!
Boy, Santana was going on all four engines.
He was cooking. He really was cooking.
Look at the grin on Fuji's face.
Fuji, yeah, ha-ha. Yes, it is. Very wise to the world of wrestling is Mr. Fuji.
Sneaking up now like a thief in the night, Dick.
Well, the people put him down and sometimes laugh at him, but he's no laughing matter to Tito Santana.
Someone to be contented with.
He sure is. All right, smash between the shoulder blades, forearm by Fuji. Phew. Even the excellent shape that Sanchez obviously is in for Santana. Really, he came down the back of his head, right on the neck. Catches a chop to the throat on that one by Fuji.
Well, that was to the blind side of the referee because that's an automatic disqualification, sure.
Well, Santana's still kind of rocky. Not being helped at all by Fuji.
Fuji now going right to work on the trapezius muscle. Excruciating pain involved with this whole thing.
All right, there's our handheld ringside camera giving a shot of the agony on Santana's face. Santana working up a quick sweat already, too. He was really cooking. He was really active for those first four or five or six in the series of maneuvers.
Well, the element of surprise was on his side, Dick, and he tried to take advantage of it and get this thing over with as soon as possible because Fuji's no one to fool around with, and if you can get it done in a minute and a half or 2 minutes, they don't pay by the hour.
A win's a win. All right, still working on the upper muscle. It's Fuji. Santana fighting off the pain. Smashes the midsection again on Fuji. Still another time. Whoa.
Fuji stopped him with a double chop there. Nice
now,
shoulder block by Fuji.
Fuji doing the shoulder block. Now,
beautiful hip block.
Woo.
Smart maneuver by Fuji.
Right back.
Right back. People don't know what this feels like, Dick, to have this hold clamped on you by someone who really knows how to apply it. And it is just, it's tough to describe the amount of pain. And in the position that Tito's in right now, it's excruciating. He must get to his knees and to his feet and get rid of some of that extra leverage that Fuji's being able to pour on right now from his vantage point.
Well, Santana may be trying just what you suggested, Gorilla Monsoon. And we'll find out shortly whether he actually can do that. He's up on one knee.
Notice when he got to one knee, Dick, Fuji immediately went to both his feet to keep that added leverage downward all the time, making his hold that much more effective.
Referee Morella right on the scene watching this very carefully. Santana still no way he can possibly move at the present time. The pain really going right to the head.
Well, you got to have a lot of stuff inside, Dick, to fight this hold. It takes that intestinal fortitude, and if anybody's got it, Tito's got it.
What determination. Look at that, fans. He's trying to get it on. Whoa! Couple blows to the midsection. Body slam, and down he goes. Shoulder block. Body chop, and down goes Santana again.
They'll go right back to that hold, I'm sure. To punish him here with a slam. Oh, he drove him into the mat. He didn't just slam him, he drove him down into that canvas.
Oh,
headbutt right to the midsection, solar plex. That'll take the wind out of you and everything else.
Fuji obviously very pleased with himself, bowing to the crowd, smiling at them. Fans indicating in return that he's number one with them. I think so. I believe that's what their gesture means, or does it?
Well, I think there's a wrong finger involved there, Dick.
Oh, Fuji still leveling Santana. Still keeping that pressure on, right back to that hold again. You call it.
Well, he's going to try to soften him up, and with a guy in the shape that Tito's in, you've got to do something if you're on Fuji's side. You've got to have some kind of a game plan as to how to take some of the starch out of this youngster who is just full of vim and vigor and in great shape and ready to go all the time.
Got nothing but energy and great strength. We've seen him for about roughly 3 years here at the Spectrum. And a crowd pleaser all the way is Tito Santana.
Tag team title on stake here tonight as well. Dick, Samoans putting it on the line against Rocky Johnson and Salvatore Palomo.
All right, we've got Tiger Chung Lee and Tony Garea. Sergeant Slaughter against Backlund for the belt. The Samoans against Rocky Johnson and Salvatore Palomo. Iron Mike Sharp and Pat Patterson. Great pair off there. George the Animal Steel and Putski. So don't go away. For heaven's sakes, don't go away. Still the pressure being applied by Fuji. This could be a lead up to the bitter end for Santana. I don't know. He hasn't been able to really break this hold of any consequence.
Well, there's an easy way to break this hold, Dick. You just scoot over and get your leg underneath or over the bottom, top of that bottom rope.
Well, some guys don't like to go that way, you know?
Well, when you're in as much pain as Tito's in right now, that'd be the route I'd go.
No argument. Here he is. Look at that.
He's face. Fighting just, it.
He really is. Still fighting.
Hand, didn't have enough steam on it to break it.
He
oh,
that
one
time.
Did.
And that one did. Ooh. Oh, man.
Illegal. Illegal maneuver.
All right.
He's
Fuji
claiming he caught him in the thigh.
He claimed to the referee hit him in the inside of the thigh. Well,
you couldn't get Tito to attest to that, I'm sure.
He might do hours debating that one with him. But caught him really where it squeaks and He's really in pain and on the rope to begin with, so the action has pretty much stopped here. Although Fuji
sneaking around.
I don't know whether they caught him in the inside of the thigh or not, because he seems to be favoring that one leg.
That was right in the solar plex.
Right over the second rope. There's grabbing hold of the nostrils and pulling back, maybe the eyes with it.
Tito's got to try to recoup here, get some things going, take a hike, get out of the ring, take a walk around, take a 7 or 8 count, get the cobwebs clear and come back in there.
No argument about that, and I'll tell you, he has had no, outside the first few seconds of the match, he hasn't really had any continuity at all in his moves.
No, it's been all Mr. Fuji.
It has been.
Since he missed the opening drop kick, it's been all Mr. Fuji.
Yep. Well, Santana is being helped by the fans. At least they're on his side.
He's jammed his head hard in that top turnbuckle.
Well, it all started, too, when he slammed the back of his head on the ring and on the ring floor. And now he's being batted around again, so... all kinds of birds.
Surprise him with the right hand.
He's putting everything he has in these shots. The Fuji. Now he's upset.
Fuji saying timeout, please.
No time now. Santana right on top of him. And he responds with a bang of the head against the top turnbuckle. Again, he does. Gonna take it the other side of the ring.
Oh, he walked right into a double karate chop right to the throat. Got his foot up on the second rope. Referee spotted it. Fuji thinks he won the match.
Oh! Uh-oh.
Fuji going in his tights right in front of the referee. High cross body. Beautiful maneuver. He got him.
Very beautiful.
And Fuji still got the salt, and he landed it right in Tito's face, and Tito is down. Right into his tight stick, grabbed what was left of that 2.5 pounds of salt, and let Tito have it right in a kisser. And Tito's eyes are burning badly right now.
They are, really. He's going to need some help getting out of the ring tonight. And so is Fuji. And the fans, that they had their way, they really do a tap dance on his head. Get the official.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time of the fall, 11 minutes, 4 seconds. Your winner, Tito Santana.
Well, that was a hard victory for Tito Santana.
It really was.
He's got to get back to the dressing room and get some water on his face, something to cut that salt out of his eyes before he does some kind of permanent injury.
All right, Gorilla Monsoon, let's check the replay. He shoves the referee. Fuji going to his tights now for that little bit of salt. However,
beautiful high cross body there by Tito. Look at him hook the leg. That's what did it, the hook in the leg.
All right, that was the takedown. Of course, that was the count out. And there'll be more upcoming here shortly, but here's some scenes first from a hilarious comedy in August on Prism with Henry Winkler. You're watching Spectrum Wrestling exclusively on Prism.
Chuck Lumley's a nice guy. Maybe too nice. And everyone knows it. In fact, the only time he gets to rest in peace is at the office.
City morgue.
Enter Bill Blazejowski.
Hi, I'm your new partner.
A man of vision with a mouth to prove it.
This is Bill. Mission in life. Make Chuck a man. We got all that space down at the morgue. All those cars, all that time at night, nobody watching us.
Pimps? Are you saying we should become pimps?
You and me, buddy!
Henry Winkler, Shelley Long, and Michael Keaton in Night Shift.
All right, Gorilla Monsoon. Yours truly, Dick Graham, here ringside at Spectrum Wrestling, World Wrestling Federation. I'll tell you, the action's fast and furious, as you've seen already, and it's going to get even more fast and furious, if you will, for you as we go along. Already in the ring, Chief J. Strongbow, and the response from the crowd directed to the other half of this matchup, the guy you recognize already, Big John Studd.
Well, originally we had a big Swede going to be in with Big John Studd, but Chief J. Strongbow is now in the ring, and oh, what a match this is going to be.
Well, this ought to be a biggie. John Studd up to the top of the ring, backs off away from Jay Strongbow. Now he's circling the ring, coming in from another direction, maybe. So as soon as he gets in the ring, we'll have the proper introductions from the ring announcer.
Checking everybody out at ringside, Greg.
Yeah.
Looking to see what he could use out there to his advantage. A piece of pipe laying around, a loose chair. He checks everything out.
I'll tell you, the man's nobody to fool with. When he walks by, I'll say, hi, sir, how are you? Which I just did.
Well, let's go up to our ring announcer and get this match going, Dan.
Wrestling fans, the following attraction is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Los Angeles, California, weighing 368 pounds, Big John Studd. And his opponent, from Pawhuska, Oklahoma, weighing in at 246 pounds, Chief J. Strongbow.
Well, we're underway. No belt, no nothing. Strongbow is after.
Underway. Chief, go for the sleeper right away. He's got it on him.
He might have him. Oh! Studd broke it through his robe over the top of Strongbow.
Chief going right out after him.
I'll tell you, man.
John Studd got the awakening of his life. Chief J didn't wait for the bell, the instructions, anything. Went right after him, slapped that sleeper hold on, and for all intents and purposes, might have got an easy victory.
He might have. He was awfully close to it. And there's a very close-up shot of John Studd favoring his throat. There's
Boy,
a count of five.
Slapped that sleeper on and dropped him right to his knees, Dave.
There's a count of seven. And back in the ring is John Studd. We'll resume where we left off, I guess. Doug's still shaking off a little bit.
Chief J laying some of that bad mouth on him. Studd a little bit bewildered.
He really is a little rocky on his feet.
Well, the Chief missed a golden opportunity.
Oh, he really did. He had him. He wouldn't have even cracked a sweat on Studd tonight. He really put him away fast. One of the ringsiders has a sign, Andre the True Giant, Studd the Giant Mistake. And there! Oh! one of the oldest holds in the business.
Never got it applied.
Never got it. Not only that, he had disadvantage.
He's just too big. He's too big for that.
Too short for it.
Surprised the Chief even attempted it. Too big a guy to do that. Notice the lack of respect for Strongbow had by the Big John Studd. He just turns his back on him at any time and does whatever he wants to do.
Now they're all yelling, Andre, Andre. Referring, of course, to Andre the Giant. Drives him crazy to hear Andre's name mentioned. Well, he turns the crowd on while Dick Worley continues to count, and Studd goes off. What do we have? Maybe.
He's halfway back to the dressing room, Dick, but I'm sure he'll be back.
Here he comes. Here he comes.
He doesn't want to forfeit this kind of purse money.
Nope. Well, Strongbow's ready for him. And it remains for Studd to get it together and get back in the ring. Maybe, maybe not. Count of three, four, five. Count of six, seven, eight, nine. Oh, he's just made it. Back in the ring again. Dick Worley counting out. I'll give credit to Studd if he can wrestle after all the hassle he's getting from the crowd. They are really on his case at the Spectrum.
Well, sometimes you can get bent out of shape like that and cost you a match at any given time.
Well, he was pointing to you. I don't know what he had to say.
I don't know what he has in mind for me, but he's got his hands full in there right now
really
with the Chief.
He does.
Doesn't he know that I'm retired, Dick?
I don't know. Listen, I still have a suspicion Gorilla Monsoon could give him plenty.
Well, look at this.
Look at him jamming
Chief
it
went
down.
For the big slam and couldn't get him up and got double hammered and dropped like a sack of potatoes.
All right, using size 13s or 14s right on the back of Strongbow.
Reverse chin lock here now. Going to siphon some of that speed and agility out of him.
He has the height. He has the leverage. He's got Strongbow right where he wants him. Strongbow down on one knee, now back off both knees.
Look at the size of the arms.
Oh, man.
My God.
The size of a lot of guys' thighs.
Fans chanting Andre, but that won't help the Chief.
The Chief is really just about hanging on, trying to get back up again. Chief down, sitting in a sitting position now. Here comes Studd on him. Smash on the neck through the shoulder blade somewhere in there. Forearm to the midsection.
Well, this guy hurts you with everything he does, Dick. His arms and
he's got all that weight behind
everything he does hurts you.
Count of three, four. Uh-oh. All right, Dick Worley warning Studd. Watch the count. Normally the Chief would be right on top of Studd. He's still a little stunned. Kicks at Studd right in the midsection. Doubles him over. Chief trying to get it on now. Kicks again. Shoulder block.
He got the worst of it there.
He really does. I wouldn't say the Chief is too light, but Stud's like a block of granite.
It's 260 pounds coming at you off those ropes. And
like a sequoia tree. All right, Chief.
Again.
Chief, go.
Right through the legs.
Oh, bear hug.
Oh, got him in a bear hug.
You talk about bad position. Punching at him. I'll tell
he's
you,
he's got to get out of here in a hurry.
He
Dick,
does.
Over.
He's got to leave town or something. Keeps smashing at him. Uh-oh.
Chief's in trouble. There's nothing left of those shots anymore.
Nope. Studd can't even feel
He's squeezing the air right out of him.
That's him.
He called for the bell. What a monster. And he's still letting him hold the hole. I can't believe it.
All right. Worley counting him, but he dropped him, and of course, collapsing like a sack of potatoes. Chief J. Strongbow. Well, all perfectly legal. There he's gone back for him again. They may have to get a couple of guys to haul them apart. And Studd doesn't even hear the count. He just drops him again. Well, Strongbow
had his opportunity early on, Dick, and once a big guy tracks you down and slaps something like that bear hug on, it's goodbye.
seconds. Your winner with a submission, Big John Studd.
All right, there you have it. That's the official. John Studd, the winner. And submission hold did it to Strongbow. Let's watch the replay. No replay, okay.
6 minutes and 48 seconds. Must have seemed like an eternity for 2J Strongbow as the big guy caught up to him.
No argument on that. No argument at all. All right. I'll tell you, the crowd's going to get on his case now, but fans, we'll be right back. But first, here's a glimpse of a movie on Prism in August.
It's Bert and Dolly together for a rollicking good time, Texas style. In the singing, dancing, musical comedy, The Best Little Whorehouse in Texas. This much fun can't be legal.
Dick Graham back at ringside with Gorilla Monsoon. And now let's go to Cal Rudman in the interview area.
Thank you, Dick Graham. Well, here we are before the big match. All I can say about the last match, the one in the garden, and plus the one here, but especially the one in the garden, I have seen this gentleman upset, but never like I saw him there. Five wrestlers jumped in. Can you explain it at all, what was going on in his mind?
Well, personally, I would like to say Jimmy was very, very upset, but I believe Jimmy should explain just how he felt about it, and I think you'll get a true picture of what was going down.
Well, let me focus. At the time, you were beating Morocco pretty badly, and five wrestlers jumped in the ring and jumped on you. You were throwing them out of the ring one by one. What was going on in your mind?
The only thing that I was thinking about is that nobody had any business at all to come and enter that ring, especially when I'm wrestling my opponent. There was no reason at all. And I don't remember mentally and physically that they say I threw out a referee. But if that's what happened, then I could accept that as a mistake. But you, Don Morocco, I just want to let you know something. Nobody comes and fight my battle along with you. Just you and me, pal. Just you and me. I don't need five wrestlers to come and hold me down for you to crawl out that ring and run away, brother. Just remember one thing. That was the last time. But this time, brother, I'm going to make sure that nobody interrupts.
Well, the referee tonight is Chief J. Strongbow. Do you have any thoughts about that?
No, I don't think any harm or any wrong against the man. I think he's a fantastic wrestler, and I could accept him as a referee. But the point is, could Don Morocco accept that? Don Morocco, the only thing you're going to have to accept, brother, is me, Jimmy Snuka, the Superfly. What you did to me, brother, just remember every dog's day comes along.
I heard you on television in Philadelphia today. You were being interviewed by Vince McMahon, and it seemed to be cut short, but you were talking about in the Fiji Islands when the men have a spear and you gore the boar with a spear and the boar is bleeding and it still comes at you, and then it was cut off. Do you want to continue? What thoughts were in your mind about that?
Like I was explaining to the people, back in the jungles, we'll break a branch off the tree and make sure that it's straight. We sharpen up the front of it and use it as a spear. But like I was trying to say, ladies and gentlemen, when you spear at a boar and it keeps coming towards you, that Don Morocco has to be some kind of a tough man. But we go all the way until we get him. That's the difference, brother.
Okay, we will return. Back to the action.
It's comedian David Steinberg at his classic best with a skit that made him one of America's favorites.
Who asked for the newlywed game to be brought back? The couples on the newlywed game will reveal the most bizarre things about each other. For a set of Samsonite luggage.
And brand new routine. Special guest John Candy.
I'll pay for it, don't worry.
David Steinberg in concert.
Cal Rudman in the back area, the world-famous Philadelphia
Spectrum. Don't tell me. I know, I realize I'm standing in front of you, in the camera. Mr. Cal Rudman, sir, how are you?
How are you?
My pleasure to see you once again.
It's my extreme pleasure to conduct this interview.
I know it has to be. Yes. What would you like to ask me? What would everybody like to know about the Magnificent One?
We would like to know about your battle with Jimmy Snuka. Jimmy Snuka, at great length, discussed the battle, how five wrestlers jumped on him, and he threw each one out of the ring as they came in, and then they came back in. He denies knowing that he threw the little skinny referee aside. So you have Chief Jay Strongbow as your referee tonight.
He's a tough son of a gun, isn't he?
Yeah, he's a tough son of a
Jimmy
gun.
Jimmy Snuka's rugged, isn't he?
Yeah, he's tough.
He's...
What was going on in your mind?
He's got it all. He's got it all together, hasn't he?
Yeah.
He can really knock him down and boy and bowl him over, can he?
Well, he was doing a lot of bleeding, but then again, so are you.
So was I.
Yeah. Tell me about it.
It doesn't matter. Didn't you come back? Didn't you come back and try and stop me from bleeding? I said, get out of here.
Yeah, you did that.
Didn't you try to do that? Because it doesn't bother me. It doesn't bother you. Can you hurt this face? Can you bother this man? Jimmy Snuka. What was he talking about? Boars and wild pigs?
Well, I guess you're a pig. He said in the Fiji Islands, when they get the spear, they break off a limb of a tree and they get it straight and sharp, and you gore the boar and it's bleeding and it keeps coming. So I guess that's you.
Well, I may be a pig. You can ask some of the ladies I've been with. Sometimes I may be a pig. I don't know. Sometimes you can't get enough. And that's exactly the case. That is exactly the case with Mr. Snuka. Because you see, when it all went back, and I wasn't talking about his mama. Let me get that. That's just Captain talking. Albano, for you ignorant people that don't know.
Be nice to the people. They're your fans.
I love you people. Believe me. But what I was talking about, how searching his soul. See, he's been standing around. He's been watching all the great wrestlers, all the great performers.
Yes.
Never once did he ask for the Magnificent One. Never once did he throw his hat into the ring. I had to go get him. So when I come to the Spectrum in Philadelphia, when I go to the Garden in New York, when I go to the sports arena in Los Angeles, wherever I go, whatever it takes, Mr. Cal Rudman, it doesn't matter who it is, I want the best. I want the toughest. You saw him knock me down. You saw him knock me down a number of times. You saw me bleed just like a pig. Just like a pig. But just like a mean boar, I got back up and tore into him.
You have just heard
bye-bye.
From the Magnificent One. Don Morocco will be right back.
I could break into your building blindfolded. Prove it.
Never before a jewel heist so daringly different. Ryan O'Neill, Ann Archer, Omar Sharif, Green Ice.
Well, Gorilla Von Soon, pandemonium breaking loose here in the Spectrum.
Fans on their feet, Dick.
They really are. Sweet hats of the guest referee. Nature Boy Buddy Rogers, the manager of Jimmy Superfly Snuka, who's in the ring now. The place is erupting with sound.
Pandemonium will break loose here tonight.
And maybe a change of the belt.
Boy, it certainly would be great to see that happen right here in the Spectrum.
The fans would love to see it. And all we need now is the appearance of the admitted magnificent Don Morocco. You'll hear him by way of the crowd. You'll know his presence is felt here. Snuka has got to be super up tonight for this. There's no other way. This guy has been primed. He's
there
ready.
He comes down the runway, Dick.
Woo!
The Magnificent One. Carrying the gold. He may be in trouble here tonight.
He's starting already.
Is for the Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship. It is set for one fall with a 1 hour time limit. Ladies and gentlemen, the guest referee for this match, Swede Hansen. Now, ladies and gentlemen, before introducing the participants, I would like to acknowledge the manager. He is the only wrestler to hold both the NWA and WWF World Heavyweight Championships. Ladies and gentlemen, Buddy Rogers.
Well, that announcement upsets Morocco no end.
And ladies and gentlemen, his protege is the challenger this evening from the Fiji Islands, 251 pounds, Jimmy Superfly Snuka. His opponent from Sunset Beach, Hawaii, 255 pounds, he is the current Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, the Magnificent Morocco.
Well, the announcements, the introductions have been made. Oh, look at that. You talk about throwing down the gauntlet. Morocco threw the championship belt at the feet of Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
Once again, Dick, I think the belt is secondary here, is a vendetta here by the Superfly.
He threw that belt at him again. And Snuka just, woo! All right, underway. Oh!
Oh, beautiful double kick.
You imagine that, can you? Oh, man.
What agility.
Oh, you kidding? Oh, I saw it, but I don't believe it. Snuka jumped up. His feet as high as the head of Don Morocco, who's about 6'2", 6'3". Whoo! What a man. Beautiful takedown. He's on top of him like a lion.
Started out the same way last month, Dick. He was right in there, right on him all the way, and holy mackerel. Superfly wants this match so bad. He wants a piece of this guy so bad that, as I said earlier, I think the belt is secondary.
It might very well be.
This is a personal vendetta.
Well, there's obviously no chokehold here. Snuka has his arm locked around the chin of Morocco. Oh, a couple of elbow jabs in the midsection by Morocco. He's taking up after a nice shoulder block by Morocco. Down goes Snuka. Oh! Beautiful.
Beautiful karate chop. Cover. He's in the ropes.
Got that leg over the ropes. Had to break it. Snuka can't
right
believe
there.
It. Snuka, his eyes, he can't believe it. She'll start all over again. Here's what began. Jeez, you talk about electricity here at the Spectrum. You could operate all the power of the lights and all the vending machines, everything, from the electricity appeal here. Tell you, fans are turned on.
Capacity crowd on hand too, Dick.
As usual. Snuka looks as if he's calm, but inside he's just churning.
Churning up.
Concentration, are you kidding? He's yanking on the jaw. on the chin area of Don Morocco. Morocco is in a dogfight tonight, fans. Make no mistake.
Morocco can take a lot of punishment, Dick. It's been proven. He's proved it to everyone. He showed it to everyone. Everybody's trying to take that title from him. No one's been successful yet, and he didn't steal it from anybody.
That's right. So you can say what you want about Morocco and boo him and hiss him and all the rest, as so many fans do. But the guy comes at you. It's not over yet, fans. Morocco a little bit desperate now, maybe trying for a half-hearted grab at the hair of Snuka.
Hansen right there.
He really is.
Excellent guest referee.
He's studying the eyes, looking right in the eyes of Morocco. Of course, who wants to submit in a situation like this? Nobody.
Morocco will never submit.
That's correct. You'll have to kill him.
And Snuka the same.
Yeah, there's inner war going on here right now. All right. Morocco back on his feet, kind of. Sort of in a half split, if you will. Trying to get his balance and I guess some of his energy back again, but Relentless is the name of Snuka. That's really his middle name, Relentless, not Superfly. He
gonna
is really
trying to turn this around into a headlock and then get rid of him.
All right,
there
breaks it off the ropes. Shoulder block and down goes Morocco.
Oh, he went for the big thumb and missed it.
And a drop kick. Morocco down like a sack of concrete. Snuka right on top of him again.
Jimmy trying to wear him down.
I think he is too. Of course, Sweet Hansen right on top of him, checking things out.
Boy, Morocco went for that big thumb off the ropes. Had he connected with that, good night.
Need to put him away. Turn out the lights.
Jimmy, quick as a cat.
And Burry, you talk about Johnny Rods being unpredictable. You can predict some of the moves from Snuka, but he's got a repertoire that won't quit. He's very unpredictable. Tonight, extremely so. Sweet Hansen still on top of the situation. Comes up almost nose-to-nose to Morocco. What about it? Morocco waves him off.
Good close-up shot there by a handheld. Show some of the scars from last month's meeting, Dick.
Well, most of these guys have scar tissue from one side of the forehead to the other. Not to mention other parts of the body, the shoulders, the arms, the hands, the knees, scar tissue. What a way to make a living. I tell you, you got to be dedicated.
You got to love it.
You got to love it.
If you don't love it, you can't survive.
You got to get out.
It's too demanding.
All right, the Superfly has grabbed the imagination of everyone nationwide. Don Morocco still in bad shape, but still trying to figure a way out.
Ooh.
Brings his leg back, catches Snuka where he lives.
Illegal maneuver.
It is, but he got what he wanted. Morocco broke the hold. Now he's in control. Grabs a head of hair, Snuka. And we've seen Morocco turn nasty.
Sleeper hold applied by Morocco. Haven't seen Don use this of late, but it's in his repertoire.
I'm debating, is that a choke hold or not, Don?
He's under the chin, Dick.
He is under the chin. I don't know.
Jimmy got to get out of here and get out of here in a hurry. Doesn't take long for the lights to go out.
Well, it looked like the legs of these super strong legs of Superfly starting to wobble just a little bit. He's not down, but he's cutting off
that flow of blood right now, Dick, to the brain. He's pinching that carotid artery with his left arm. That stops the flow of blood to the brain carrying the oxygen.
Oh my God. Gave it back to him. Came right off back for the same maneuver. Illegal? Yeah. Was
payback
it justified?
Time.
Yeah, payback time. All right.
Well, the score is 1-1 now, Dick.
For sure. But Morocco back again.
Nice
get an elbow. Morocco near the ropes. Snuka.
Snuka definitely in control right now.
He is. Uh-oh.
Oh, vicious headbutt. Morocco flat on his back in the center of the ring. Jimmy going up on the inside to the second turnbuckle.
He's going up to the 747 where they fly.
Headbutt. Oh, he nailed him.
And he's cracked the skin of Morocco anyway.
Morocco busted open once again. Superfly loves it.
He better put him away. Morocco covered with blood.
Seen Morocco absorb a lot of punishment. They can still come back.
Oh, right into either the turnbuckle or the ring post. But I'll tell you, the blood is just streaming down. I see fear in the eyes of Don Morocco. He knows that belt, that championship, his pride is almost gone.
Brian Mayer takes him over. He's setting him up for another headbutt. Oh. Nailed him right on the same spot.
The blood just running in different directions down the face of Don Morocco from the forehead. And the Superfly is right back on it again.
I don't think Morocco can see anymore. That blood starts running in your eyes.
Outside
over the
top rope
and out of here.
He hits the floor. I mean the concrete floor of the Spectrum. Not just the floor, it's all concrete. Our ringside camera right on the scene. There's a shot of almost a vanquished champion.
Referee can't count because Jimmy's standing on the outside of the ring apron.
He's got to count up.
He's looking
though
to come down on him here, and he does.
Morocco barely hanging on to the ring apron. However, the count can begin now. What do we got? Count of three. All right, now the count has to be held up.
Jimmy's relentless. He's not going to let up on him for a second. Morocco, if he's got it inside him, he's really got to reach down tonight to survive this onslaught by the Superfly.
Well, you talk about pride. Here it is, a head. Whoa! Woo! How much more punishment can Morocco take? Here he comes, flying again. Woo! It's beyond beating a
Jimmy's
man.
Jimmy's going outside now. Dickie's going to go up to the top turnbuckle. What will it be?
Morocco grabbing hold of Hanson, trying to lift himself.
Oh, Morocco pulled Hanson out in front, and the Superfly landed right on the back of the big Swede.
And the Swede is out of it.
He's hurt.
Oh, man. Hanson can do no good. It wouldn't matter if 15 referees were in the...
He got him once again. Schnucker's down.
Uh-oh, he's pulling the belt. He's going to whip him.
Oh, my God.
Oh, Morocco whipping the Superfly.
Superfly coming back now. Jimmy's got the belt.
Now he's using the buckle.
Sweet Hanson lost control here. He's out of it. Oh, he whipped him right off the ropes with the belt, and down goes Morocco.
Morocco down on all fours.
This match is out of control.
It really is. Hanson cannot help or hinder. A headbutt. There goes the champion over the top of the ring ropes.
Swede now going over towards the timer's table here.
He'd like to count, but
calling for the bell. Morocco exiting in a hurry. Wow, did he take a shellacking.
They called time.
I think he counted Morocco out of the ring.
Well, the belt and the championship cannot pass to Snook in this case at this point.
Not on a disqualification or count out.
But obviously, Snuka, the winner. Let's get the announcement here. Make it official. Sweet Hanson talking to Gary Capetta.
Hanson is in pain.
He really is. All right, let's get it.
Ladies and gentlemen, at 11 minutes, 26 seconds, referee Sweet Hanson counts out of the ring. The Magnificent Morocco the winner of the match, Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
The fans are on their feet.
Snuka's not happy about it. Look at his face.
Of course not.
We get a shot of Jimmy's face. He's not happy about it.
Sweet Hansen near our vantage point, still favoring the small of his back. Superfly going off. Well, don't go away, fans. We're coming right back with more action, if you can stand it. You're watching Spectrum Wrestling exclusively on Prism.
His name is Detective Danny Jello.
We make cases. There'll be big ones. You'll be the state star witness.
He sees life as we will never see it.
If I decide to do this, then I will not give up my partners.
He is Prince of the City.
Detective Daniel Cello, Special Investigating Unit, Narcotics Division, Your Honor.
Is it common practice to sell narcotics in the Narcotics Division?
We're not dope dudes, we're policemen.
He's seen too much.
Was Moscone a partner?
He's a friend.
He's federal level. I want him.
He knows too much.
Your people are out to get you worse than anybody on our side.
He said too much.
In their hearts, they want to admit their guilt. That's the way cops are. That's how you got here.
He's gone too far to stop.
Wait a minute, I'm a cop! Come on, up! Get out!
Treat Williams is Prince of the City.
Gorilla Monsoon, this is Dick Graham. We're live here watching the replay. The action as Morocco begins to whip with Sweet Hansen's belt the body of Jimmy Superfly Snuka. The events leading up now through the end.
Snuka. Well, as soon as the big Swede went down, Dick, he reached right down and unstrapped his belt buckle, took the belt off, went to work on it, and holy mackerel, what a confrontation. We haven't seen the last of that.
No, Dick. that's going to surface again and again. Well, let's get on more craziness here. Here's our next match.
Wrestling fans, the following contest set for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right, from Korea, he weighs 275 pounds, making his first appearance in the Philadelphia Spectrum, Tiger Chung Lee. And his opponent from Auckland, New Zealand, weighing 244 pounds, Tony Garea.
Undefeated, Tiger Chung Lee makes his debut here in the Spectrum, and just another indication of the caliber of wrestling brought to you by the World Wrestling Federation, Dick. Unbelievable matches here tonight.
Unbelievable, also very unpredictable. Chung Lee just went at a very alert Tony Garea with his bamboo.
Well, he came into the ring with that kendo stick.
Yes,
I understand
did.
He's a master of kendo and as well as a master of many of the martial arts. Remains to be seen how well he does in the World Wrestling Federation, because he's in there with a tough cookie right now.
Really tough. Garea is dynamite.
You don't
all
become
right, on the ropes and not a clean break.
You don't get to be five-time co-holder of the World Tag Team Championship by accident.
For sure. Why the
pressure point here?
He really is. Well, he's starting early, trying to wear down Garea. Taking advantage.
Fans are really not into this match. They're still buzzing over the last match, Dick.
They're still wiping the sweat. I'll tell you, they're stunned. They're worn out. You know, when they leave here, they've left all their emotions right on the floor of the Spectrum. I'll tell you, they give it.
Absolutely.
They are into this. They love the World Wrestling Federation and all the exciting matches here every month on Prism. Chung Lee still on top of Garea. However, he's on the ropes. They got a break, count of two or three, and he does break. Yes. Yes,
most of these wrestlers, Dick, we see come out of the Oriental countries as Mr. Fuji of Japan and now Tiger Chung Lee of Korea. These guys are all, since day one, since the first time they can put on a pair of wrestling tights or wrestling boots, they seem to know and favor the martial arts. I guess it's part of their upbringing, their custom.
It's their custom, it's their heritage, and also their discipline. They love the disciplines of it. And they love to punish. Garea back where he was before with the
strength-draining hold by Tiger Chung Lee.
Well, Tony's got to rely on his speed and agility here and experience and knowledge. And you're in there with a guy like Chung Lee who comes into here undefeated, looking to make a name and a rep for himself in the World Wrestling Federation because he realizes this is the mecca for professional wrestling. This is where the greats of the entire wrestling world come to make a name for themselves. And Tony, I'm sure, doesn't want to be used as a stepping stone.
No. Not only that, but, you know, anywhere else, not to put other people down, but this is the mecca, and this is where it really is. You want to make your reputation here. This is the majors. This is the major league. All right, Chung Lee still maintaining that pressure on Gurria. Gurria's got a half-doubled fist. He's thinking, but the pain's quite...
Well, he's right underneath that tricep, in the back of that tricep, and that can be one of the most excruciating parts of your body as far as pain is concerned. And you can see by Tony's face that he's not enjoying this one bit.
Well, he's on his feet now, and I don't know what kind of leverage he can get. If he does, he gives Chung Lee a smash to the face again, but still he maintains that pressure. Now they're both in the ropes. Gurria backed up there. Chung Lee's still right back with him. Back in the box again as Gurria is.
Tony's suffering right now.
This is night for sneaking up on, huh? Chung Lee goes right back on him. But they're on the ropes, and then by all intents and purposes should break the hold at this point.
Well, Chung Lee, some 265 pounds. He don't need to sneak up on anybody.
He doesn't have to.
Walk right in the front door.
He's like a cat lion in the tall grass.
Tony trying to shake it off. Probably wish he was back in Auckland. He'll get his thing going. Just
maybe the start of it here. Smash, forearm smash down the back of the head. The
nice
area.
Forearm by Gurria.
All right, now we're going to apply a little bit of pressure on Chung Lee, says Tony Gurria.
Really got that arm wringer wrung out there. Good shape.
All right, the crowd's starting to respond, trying to transfer some of their energies and desires to their emotions to Gurria.
I don't know how the crowd's got any energy left.
That's
and we
true.
Haven't even reached the main event yet.
We haven't even gotten to Backlund, and of course his opponent tonight, Sergeant Slaughter, and that shall be a biggie. I don't know how you top anything after Snuka and Morocco just a while ago.
Well, it just seems to keep building. Tony really applying pressure now on the elbow. He's trying to hyperextend that elbow. It's just not constructed that way. We don't work that way.
Off the rope, shoulder block. Down goes Chung Lee.
Went
Whoa! Arm drag.
Surprised him.
Nice drag of the arm, and down goes Chung Lee.
Chung Lee went for a backdrop, and Tony just slipped that right leg right over the top of him, hooked around, spun, come up with a beautiful arm drag, and he's got control once again.
Sure does. Yeah, the Samoans going against Rocky Johnson, Salvatore Palomo, Iron Mike Sharp later on against Pat Patterson, everybody's favorite. Koloff and Knudel against the Invaders later. And do you believe George the Animal Steel and Ivan Putski?
Wow.
But it doesn't stop. It really doesn't. Well, Gurria still maintaining that pressure on the arm, the shoulder area.
You know, each one of those bouts you mentioned, it could be a main event in any major arena in the entire country.
Sure could, and would.
Beautiful arm drags by Gurria.
Right back again.
Really got underneath and got that high leverage.
All right, Tony Gurria is studying concentration. That face just almost like stone. He's thinking, is it like, you almost see the wheels turning behind the eyes. One maneuver coming up after another. He's laying them out, it seems to be. What he does after this one. If Chung Lee counters with one thing, what he does after that. They're always thinking ahead. Oh, Chung Lee gone for the head.
Karate chop right to the side of the face.
Staggers Gurria. He's on the second rope. Smash to the top of the head. Chop to the top of the head and throw the forehead again. Very businesslike now. Here come those two fingers right down the throat area.
That's an illegal maneuver.
It really is. No, I see. I understand.
That Chung can Lee. Break your esophagus. And
he nods in assent that he understands the referee. However, he goes right back again. Count of two. Referee pulls his hand away. Chung Lee not liking that very well. He's being warned. Oh, yes. I understand, finally. Maybe.
Well, he understood a long time ago.
He really did. All right. He's got the pressure. He's standing there, three on both knees, and now Chung Lee with a lot of leverage and a lot of strength building through those arms and fingers into the shoulder, the neck area of Tony Garea. Garea right now not in the best of situations. You got to admit that. There's a shot of the face, the pain, the agony on the face of Garea with our ringside camera. These guys don't miss much. Got a great.
Oh, they're doing an excellent job.
They do a terrific crew here. Terrific crew. They do an excellent job.
Well, we had a chance for three titles to change hands here tonight, Dick. One's gone by the wayside. Samoan's still coming up. Their title on the line. Of course, Backlund's title on the line against the Sarge. Nice maneuver here by Chung Lee, distracting, turning the referee away at the same time he was choking Tony Garea.
There he goes with that, those two extended fingers into the throat of Garea. And right back again. No speak English. Hi, fan, how are you? I'll be you, fan.
Tony's in a lot of trouble.
He really is. Comes down with a shot. Oh, mercy. Garea better, it's easy to say at this point, but Garea's got to get something going. He's just taking a terrible punishment right
or
now.
Or he'll be going.
You bet.
You let this big guy stop on you and bang at you for any length of time.
Feel the pressure he keeps applying. He just stood there with one foot, the foot with the bandage around the ankle. And there he is, back in the same maneuver again. Right on the throat. Referee keeps talking to him. The guy keeps smiling and nodding, but don't believe he understands or wants to. All right, referee asking to submit. Well, how about it, Tony Garea? Had enough? You won't get anything around Tony. No way. No way.
Well, Garea down there quivering.
He really is.
Never seen Tony quite this put out, taking advantage of this much by any individual. Tiger Chung Lee may be someone to be reckoned with here.
Garea trying to get that strength together. He knows it's now or never. Now or never for sure.
Plants
right,
an elbow.
Another elbow. Still another elbow. Finally breaks the hold. Off the rope, shoulder block. Down goes Chung Lee. Oh, sunset flip. No, not quite. What Chung did?
He caught a foot right in the ear.
All right. Caught a heel maybe. Chung Lee right sneaking up on him again. Right back to the shoulder. Chop to the chin.
Oh! Nice reversal.
All right. Garea had enough. Enough is enough, he says. Chung Lee, come get it. I got it for you. Oh! Kick the midsection. Kick again. Into the ring turn. Fuck, go! The worm has turned. Garea into the ropes, shoulder block, down goes Garea over the rope, outside the ring, down goes Chung Lee.
I think Tony got the worst of that, Dick.
He really did. Maybe caught the shoulder a little, then a high.
Well, he spun that shoulder right in up under his chin, I think, and that's where he's been taking all that abuse all evening. Doesn't look good for Tony. He's still on the deck. Now he's up. Nice shoulder.
Block.
Drives him back.
Wait, the bell. The bell, that... He didn't beat the count, I guess.
I don't think he made it.
Didn't beat the count. It seems to be. We'll get the official here shortly. Chung Lee wandering past our broadcast location.
Well, Tony was out on the deck there quite a while.
And Chung Lee, even though he was flat on his back for a time, he was still in the ring. Let's get the official.
Ladies and gentlemen, at 11 minutes, 12 seconds, Tony Garea can it out of the ring. The winner of the match, Tiger Chung Lee.
All right, Chung Lee, the winner.
Well, Tony having a few words with the young referee.
Well,
it was out on the floor for quite a bit of time, and there was nothing there to break the hold, so.
I don't think Garea, he climbed right back to. Let's get a replay going here. But Garea, you know, won't walk away from anybody. But I think he realizes, yeah, it's honest. He blew it.
Well, Tony jammed him into the turnbuckle here in pretty good fashion.
All
as
right.
The big chunger took a heavy drop to the mat canvas. Now Tony comes right up strong again, grabs that side headlock, but Chung's having no part of it. Shoots him off into the. Now watch his spin around. Look at how he caught him right with that left shoulder, right underneath Tony's chin. Takes him out over the top, and he's on the deck.
So the point, Greer outside Chung Lee, even though he's flat, he's inside the ring. The count began. Okay, fans, let's say more. August 21st is action-packed Sunday on Prism, and here is a sample.
Go to South America and search for emeralds with Ryan. Space where Sean Connery finds nothing but trouble as a marshal trying to keep law and order in Outland. And take to the air with Clint Eastwood as an ace out to steal a plane with a mind of its own in Firefox. Prism will bring your weekend to a far from quiet close on Action Pack Sunday, August 21st. Be watching.
Gorilla Monsoon, yours truly, Dick Graham here. And looks to be, we'll resume action momentarily. And you're going to check out the next match as we see the appearance of the Samoans.
There
they come.
Oh,
they are beautiful, huh? Woo! Ah, Pasika, the Samoans.
Just another pretty face, Dick.
Just another. A couple of guys are just trying to get along in the world, you know, get along with everybody. You buy that, I'll sell you the spectrum.
They are devastating.
They really are. Okay, the Samoans in the ring, they're wearing the belts, showing their superiority as tag team champions. And we'll meet the other two in just a moment.
Waiting for the appearance of Rocky Johnson and Salvatore Bellomo.
Saw Bellomo early tonight before anybody was in the spectrum giving a wrestling lesson to a young fella. Just showing him some holds and whatnot.
Boy, he can do it.
Yes, he can.
He knows some holds.
And he was watching this with great interest, standing on the ringside. And Bellomo really was showing how to do certain maneuvers and put the whole body into it for leverage. And boy, he's making his point. All right, we see the Samoans still pacing back and forth.
Maybe a little strategy here on the part of Rocky Johnson and his partner. Let these guys get out here in the ring and sort of hang loose out there for a while and let them think about it.
Maybe.
Crowd coming to life here. Here they come now, Dick.
All right. All right, Rocky Johnson in the lead. His colorful robe. And right behind him is Salvatore. So look, you talk about looking good and in shape. These guys ought to compliment themselves very, very well.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following match is for the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship. It is set for one fall with a 1 hour time limit. Introducing the challengers to my left, from Italy, weighing 241 pounds, Salvatore Bellomo. His tag team partner from Washington, D.C., 250 pounds, Rocky Johnson. And wrestling fans, their opponents, total combined weight, 613 pounds from the Isle of Samoa. They are the current World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Afa Sika, the Wild Samoans.
Wild is not descriptive enough for these two individuals.
No, we got to find a few adjectives somewhere, if possible, that have not been used. Checking out Rocky Johnson, kind of a colorful tights he's wearing with RJ on the side front, if you will, the front, I guess. And he's looking so good, as he always does. Bolobo looks like a big kid. He's so enthusiastic about wrestling. And you want to get a shot of this, Mr. Monsoon? We got to turn it over. Here's what it's all about, fans. Here are the two belts combined. There's the one in the front. But there they are. That's what it's all about. That's what Johnson, Bolobo, won tonight.
Quest
that's
for the gold.
You bet. Boy, they're beautiful, too.
And they're heavy.
Yeah, they've been used as weapons a few times along the way. Looks to be Johnson goes out. Bolobo stays in. And the Samoan's going to get ready to part company here. One will remain in while the other goes out. Uh-huh. All right. Bolobo, very, very, very agile.
Be interesting to see if the team of Bolobo and Rocky Johnson have any continuity here, Dick. To the best of my knowledge, I don't think either one of these individuals has teamed together with his partner tonight in the past.
That's right. Dick Worley warning one of the Samoans back to the corner. He was wandering too far. He got those ropes at the either corner for a very specific purpose. You got to hang on to that.
Now, two great wrestlers in their own right, Dick, but in a tag team match, you need that continuity. You need to know what your partner is thinking as well as what he's thinking about doing in there.
All right.
And the Samoans, you know, have that 100%. Whether Johnson and Bolobo can get that together here tonight, it remains to be seen.
That's a nasty face if I ever saw one. I think Bolobo's attention has been gotten by the Samoan. I think not that he wasn't paying attention, but I think a little more concentration on behalf of Salvatore right now, the side headlock. And going now to the other, whoa, shoulder block. This
beauty.
Is shoulder block night.
Nice whoa. Cartwheel.
Nice.
Nicely frog and a beauty kick to beauty.
Fans of her. They came alive over that one. Woo!
Beautiful sequences.
He had it all
by Bolobo.
He really had it.
I love that mule kick.
Yeah, isn't it beautiful? Especially when somebody else is getting it. Anybody ever do? I guess hard to remember. You've had so many matches. Anybody
Dick,
ever do that?
It all was probably done to me, Dick. Everything was done to me over the 21 years.
Legally and illegally. I guess it's a dumb question on my part, but you never know.
Afa a little more cautious now. He's after feeling the wrath of Mr. Bolobo's arsenal.
Oh,
Nelson.
Bull Nelson's right. he's moving along a little bit. Rocky. Uh-oh. Get out.
Reversed it.
He reverses the Bull Nelson. Oh! He says, boy, am I going to get yelled at for that one, huh? What a dummy, he's saying. He's calling himself everything. Bolobo
has made
the tag. Okay. Rocky Johnson vaults the ropes like a feather. Here he goes. Now he's going to go to work. Johnson, really a beautiful wrestler. Great bod, always in shape, always ready.
Very well liked by his peers, as well as the fans. Right? Very highly respected.
Yep, they're yelling, Rocky, Rocky.
Johnson for the ride. Nicely frogged.
Whoa!
What a drop kick. A lolly shuffle there. Takes him over with an arm wringer.
He threatened him with a size 13 right across the head. Didn't do it, though. Dick Worley warning Bolobo to get off the second rope. He does. Nice lock on the Samoan by Rocky. Look at the shoulders. Look at Johnson, just a stud, just one muscle after another. Took a lot of time to get in shape like that, Band. You gotta recognize that back.
Well, it doesn't happen by accident.
No. All right, Palomo takes the tag from Rocky Johnson. And before they split, Palomo in command again. Johnson barely breathing hard. Guy's incredible.
Sika yet to be legally in the ring here in this match. Still wandering around out there in the apron.
All right.
Not sure what time the bus comes by.
Who cares, maybe. All right, Palomo on the ropes. Misses the chop. Oh, and that gets another chop, and down he goes.
He didn't miss that one.
Oh, right across the throat. He says, got to use my head. Hoffa says, yeah, I got it figured out. He's in bad territory right here.
In the wrong corner.
Oh, yeah. Tag made. Sika coming in.
Watch a double team effort here.
Whoa!
Wide open.
Took all that shot. Rocky Johnson dying to jump in and help out. And he's yelling to Palomo, come on, man, come on.
It's a terrible feeling, Dick, when you're standing out there holding that rope and
you want to help a
guy. Your partner's in trouble and there's nothing you can do about it. It gets very frustrating.
Johnson, yeah, he says, come on, man, come on, come on, do it. Get up, Palomo. Come on, babe. Come on, do it. Palomo trying to fight off that paralyzing pain. Wants to get up. Up one knee. Palomo is a nice guy, very engaging to talk to, but he's a tough cookie. Gotta be tough. You better be tough. We're getting another business. All right. Zeke is still applying that pressure and glad to be doing it, too. He loves it. Really loves it.
Referee Dick Worley right in there asking if he wanted to quit, but I doubt that very much. Drop some big elbows.
Oh! Shoulder block and moves the Samoan a few feet. Oh,
caught a block right in the back.
Caught a foot right in the back, the Samoan
right
back,
in the
and down he went.
Rocky stepped right in. That referee's going to put him out now in a double team effort by the Samoans.
Oh, a headbutt.
Vicious headbutt.
And now we've got off the back of the ring because the tag was made, although Worley did not see it, and Palomo's in big trouble. Another headbutt. He's almost seeing a black George the Animal Steel. That headbutt, he's ferocious. All right. Dick Worley checking things out here with Palomo. Ordering. Up in the ring, Sika doing a number toward Rocky Johnson. Johnson. Well, we got something going on between the other two guys outside the ring. Palomo still taking a beating inside the ring. Not a usual kind of a physical beating, but still.
We're only trying to maintain some semblance of order here. Push Rocky back, and the other Samoan comes in a double team effort now.
And now they tag. And Worley's looking, he says, wait a minute, which one of you guys, wait a minute, hold it, hold it.
He's not sure which one's
no.
in there. I'm not sure which one's in there half the time.
No, and that's an advantage for the Samoan.
Absolutely. One of their greatest attributes. Rocky frustrated.
All right, Palomo with a shot to the midsection. There to the back of the head, a tag made. And takes a chop and down he goes. And man, the Samoans are mean. Mean as crocogators, would you say?
Absolutely. Rocky's getting disgusted out there on the ring apron. He feels useless. Nothing he can do at the moment.
Oh, my God.
Woo!
He went over head high. And I mean, when he crashed, felt the small of his back, and I'm telling you, he's trying to crawl over to Rocky Johnson. Johnson better, we can stretch that far to tag him, but Paloma would like dearly to have a rest tonight.
Well, Paloma, I'm sure, had the wind knocked out of him from that big, huge, high backdrop.
And instead of a back body drop by the Samoan on Paloma, Paloma kicked him. And here we go, a tag bait. Rocky Johnson on a tear. Look out, he'll take them both on. And look at that. He is on a trip.
Johnson, a house of fire.
He's putting him away, for real.
Abdominal stretch here. He's got it on him. This could be it. No, Sika comes in and lowers the boom.
Paloma
now in. Ducked under that big chop, ducked under the second one.
And a fly takedown. Two.
Beautiful high cross body, almost got him. Four men inside the ring now.
And I don't think Dick Worley's going to be.
Well, trying to get Rocky Johnson out. Paloma's left in there alone now. Two Samoans, look out. Double headbutt. Good
Double
night.
Double headbutt. Put him away. The lights went out. All right, he's got it. One, two, and a three, and that's it.
Could not withstand a double headbutt, Dick. Nobody gets up from that.
Well, Paloma's still writhing in pain on the floor of the ring. Rocky Johnson talking to him, trying to get him back up again. Jimmy's
one
all right.
Split second. One split second. Referee Dick Worley trying to put Rocky Johnson outside the ring. At the same instant, both Samoans in the ring with a double headbutt. Let's get the official time.
All right, there it is.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time of the match, 10 minutes, 26 seconds. The winners and still World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Apa, Sika, the Wild Samoans.
There they go, holding their belts up in a token of victory.
All right, check the screen, watch the replay.
Rocky Johnson here couldn't take it anymore. Came in, started really lowering the boom on Sika. Now look at Dick Worley pushing out poor Rocky Johnson, who doesn't want to go at the same time. The big double headbutt. Nobody survives that. It was curtains from that point on. Salvatore had no chance. Samoans
on
to victory.
All right, off right on top. There's the count of three, and that's that. Well, let's catch our breath here, fans. The Sixers, the Flyers, the Phillies, pro boxing, pro wrestling. Where? Right here in prison. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
Sharp trying to indicate to Pat Patterson he's going to put him away.
One ball with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, weighing in at 286 pounds, Iron Mike Sharp. And his opponent from San Francisco, California, weighing 237 pounds, Pat Patterson.
All right, you got the announcement and just about ready to get underway. And you know, with Iron Mike Sharp, anything can happen, and Pat Patterson has got to be at his best tonight.
Boy, they call this guy a wimp, Dick, but he's a long way from being a wimp. This guy's a fanatic when it comes to conditioning. But he's in there with a real ring veteran tonight, and this is going to be one heck of a confrontation.
For sure. And Pat, oh, they're underway.
Crisscross. He caught him right in on the sunset flip with a roll-up. He could get him here. Oh, beautiful. Two close. Almost got him.
Classic maneuver by Pat Patterson.
Pat slipped right in behind him, ran him right in, and rolled him right up. But
Sharp doesn't like to do this. He doesn't like to see the weird. The worm turns so fast, he says, wait, ought to be in control.
Patterson now leading the cheer for the wimp.
He says, I'll get you for that, he's telling Patterson.
Saying, I'm not a wimp. Crisscross once more. Who's going to end up on the short end of the stick?
Oh!
Sunset flip by Patterson. Oh, he's two and a half.
Woo. Patterson almost had him.
Twice in a row, he got him with that same maneuver, but two and a half count, couldn't quite get it.
Call him a whip if you will, but he's somebody to be reckoned with. He is upset. Doesn't like the way things have gone here. Almost got taken out twice by the same maneuver by Pat Patterson. Whoa!
Oh, he
pulls that forearm wrapping.
Hey, whip!
Forearm smash and down goes Patterson.
Anytime he whacks you with that forearm wrap, you're in trouble. It's a weapon. Jumped up to get some extra leverage that time. I don't really think he needs it when he uses that.
He's got a lot of strength. Got to break it on the ropes. Count of three there. Dick Worley, Butting is right back to it again. Count of three, breaks it up again. Sharp gets a little bit crazy. He doesn't even follow the rules. Doesn't even care about them.
Very unorthodox style. He's adjusting it now. He's adjusting that forearms supporter, so to speak. Now, Patterson could be in trouble here. Oh, he nailed it with him. Knocked Pat right outside.
Right outside the ring. He waffled him alongside the head, and out he went. Pat Patterson down, as you can see. I'll tell you, Iron Mike Sharp is just that. He's a tough cookie. Fans will dispute that, but who really can? If you really follow wrestling, the guy is tough.
Patterson's down, and I'll be so very surprised if he gets back on his feet.
And Sharp going outside for him now. Here he goes. He's
going to throw Patterson back into the ring.
He wants to get him back in. He's going to follow.
Boy, that could be a big mistake right there.
He might let him be counted out. Get it over with. Comes a ball.
Oh, small package. He small package him. He got him.
I
don't believe it.
What a maneuver by Pat Patterson. Woo. He doesn't believe it. Sharp doesn't believe it. He says no, no, and nobody's hearing him. Nobody's paying attention to him. trying everything. Sharp declaring to Dick Worley that Patterson grabbed his trunks in the midst of pinning. No way. Let's get the announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time of the fall, 3:32. Your winner, Pat Patterson.
All right, they're still going at it. It's not over. Patterson gone after Steele. Gone after Sharp. Gone after him again. Woo!
Sharp's out under the bottom, and he's going to keep going. I'm sure he doesn't want any more Patterson this evening.
He doesn't. He might say he does. No, he doesn't. He's got that. Whoa! He started up the steps with a chair. You talk about a guy who's TO'd. He's really ticked off. Well, that's it. Sharp, apparently. Spinning it, Patterson. Patterson's come on in. I don't know that Sharp wants any more, but he's getting more of Patterson. Dick Worley hanging on for dear life. Hang on to Pat Patterson. Sharp goes off, and that's the end of that. Woo. Check the replay, fans. Don't go away. Here's where it started. Sharp down on the floor on top of Patterson.
Big mistake.
Stands him up, pushes him back in the ring, and that's where the end began.
That was the beginning of the end for the Wimp tonight. That was his first mistake. Throwing Pat Patterson into the ring, he could have easily been counted out there on the floor. Now he comes back in. He's going to pick him up for a power slam here. Look at Pat. Beautiful small package. Shoulders are right down there. Good night, Irene.
And Gorilla Monsoon and I will be right back with more of the nonstop action of professional wrestling exclusively on Prism.
Spend an hour with Tony Bennett.
Someone start believing in you.
And the music of Cole Porter, George Gershwin, Irving Berlin, and more.
You must remember this. A kiss is still a kiss.
It's Tony at his best, singing the kind of songs that have made him one of the most popular performers of our time.
I left my heart San Francisco.
Tony Bennett.
Your golden sun will shine for me.
With love.
Dick Graham back here at ringside. Gorilla Monsoon and I bring you the next action. Sergeant Slaughter already in the ring. And of course, waiting the arrival of the champion, Bob Backlund.
Sergeant giving his rendition of the Marine hymn.
Well, Sinatra, David Bowie, Billy Joel all can sleep very well tonight.
There's a shot of Arnold Skolin, the manager of the champ, Bob Backlund.
Backlund coming in, and he looks loaded for bear. Woo! Now Backlund has the swagger stick.
Ringside champion thrown into the ring. Bob Backlund pulling out all the stops. Going for broke here. Boy, he's hot.
He is super hot tonight. Off comes the jacket, the towel. He still holds on to the whip, though. Slaughter yelling next to us, get that whip away from him. He yells to the referee. Backlund says, come on, let's have it. Let's go.
But I think Backlund's got it stuck in the back of his tights.
He kept the whip, and that's not over yet. All right. There's that whip sticking straight up in the back. Whoa, he's beating on him. Backlund, I'll tell you, I've never seen him resort to that kind of act before, but I'll tell you, he won't back off from anybody. He knows that this is bad trouble to him.
Well, he took a tremendous beating from that whip several weeks ago here on national television on the World Wrestling Federation Championship Wrestling.
And he remembered.
Slaughter really did a number on Dick. He carried those welts around on his body for some 3 or 4 weeks, and now Bob's trying to get even.
Well, he's raised a bad welt on top of Slaughter again, and Backlund is ready. What a grudge match this is, fans. He's got Slaughter on Queer Street.
Oh, Slaughter heavily into the top rope. Banged his head on that top post.
He's just about hanging by a thread.
Backlund trying to keep him back inside the ring.
Oh, pile driver! No! Backlund is on a tear. Woo!
Oh, Slaughter right over the top rope.
Came close, somebody's gonna wind up on my lap.
Just missed smashing his head into the ring steps.
We've got this metal television receiver here, and I thought for sure Slaughter's gonna be right on top of that.
Spectrum fans on their feet as Sergeant Slaughter is taking a beating here at the hands of the champ, Bob Backlund. Tried to reach up and get that rope and never made it.
Still can't get up. Still trying like crazy. You talk about a guy who's really in a fog. I might give him his credit. He's trying to get up. Woo!
Over the top rope with that slingshot move as Backlund brings him back.
Backlund takes him underneath the armpit. He's doing it to him tonight. You talk about a guy who's out for revenge. He wants the head. Literally the head of Sergeant Slaughter. He's just pounding, no finesse, no finesse at all. Backlund just pounding on him.
Backlund going to work on that left arm of the Sarge, trying to soften it up for what everybody's waiting for, the chicken wing and crossface. Sergeant trying to get that arm out of there because he knows what this is leading up to.
He knows he's in bad trouble. He knows he's wobbly, man. He's right on the edge.
Backlund has so many ways to beat you, but that's his favorite, that chicken wing crossface.
He let him go as if Slaughter was going into the corner. They just pulled him up short, had him tumble down.
He really is going to work on that arm now.
Working on him for sure. Backlund is business and all business tonight. More so than usual, maybe.
Nice reversal by the Sergeant. Nobody home. He rammed that left shoulder that's already been taking a beating right into the steel post.
Backlund, quick as a cat, dodged out of the way. Backlund's not finished yet. I'll tell you. I'm not necessarily feeling sorry for a guy, but you got to give credit to Slaughter. A lot of guys just let him put him away and get it over with. He keeps getting up.
Sarge has got a lot of guts.
If he does, like him or not, you got to admit it.
One of the toughest men ever to come to the World Wrestling Federation. Doesn't have to take a back seat to anybody, and on any given night can take the title away from anyone.
Backlund is almost trying to tear the arm off, I tell you, right in the socket. He's got a long memory, this Backlund. The whip's been thrown aside, but that doesn't mean that Backlund has lost his desire to grind this guy right into the floor.
Backlund trying to separate that left arm. Boy's going to work on, he's beating that elbow viciously.
And the crowd's picking up the chant now. You talk about agony. No. Slaughter says no. He shakes his head. No, not going to give in. Can't. too much at stake, too much pride here. Bracken over the thigh again. Bracken on a tear. I don't know how much more Slaughter can take.
Boy, he can take it, I'll tell you that, Dick.
Oh, yeah. Gorilla Monsoon, these guys, really incredible. I don't really understand where he's coming from. What a beating. Backlund really giving it to him tonight. A lot of payback time involved here.
Well, he's got his taste of revenge. He was humiliated on National.
All right, whoa!
Now he's getting it back.
Back again. That pain shooting right up the back, right under his head. Backlund just, you know, how strong he is. His stories about him are legend, about working out, keeping in shape, and all that energy, all that superhuman strength.
Does phenomenal things. Just phenomenal.
500 sit-ups at the crack. I just go on and on.
Nice maneuver there by the Sarge.
Slaughter came back and gave a shot, and down both men go. Backlund favoring his throat. The count going on. 3, 4. Down to 5. Down to 6. Down to 7. All right. Backlund kind of up. The Sarge is on his feet.
Sarge sneaking around looking for that Cobra clutch, but he couldn't get it.
And what happened?
He went to put a side headlock on, and that left arm is so sore he couldn't do anything with it. He couldn't hold it.
Backlund over on him now. Going back on it again. If Slaughter survives this, I mean, I don't know how in the world he has enough strength left, especially that one arm. Well, you can't forecast these things. You don't know. There's such
strength. Boy, that left arm is in bad shape, I'll tell you that, Dave.
Kick the midsection of Backlund by Slaughter. Taking it to the turnbuckle.
Backlund just missed whacking his head on that ring post.
Might have been all over. Now Backlund hanging by a thread on top of the top ring on the rope. Now Slaughter's payback time. He's on the ring. He's on the rope. Surely they got, all right, he's back in again. I just say, clearly on top of the rope. They had to stop it.
Boy, Backlund took a shot there right in the solar plex. Oh, look at that maneuver. Boy, that'll take the starch out of you.
Well, in great shape as Backlund is, that had to hurt all the way. Here's bringing him our way into the ropes.
Backlund for the ride. Oh, dropped right to his knees and planted that elbow right in the solar plex again.
Maybe he's got him. I don't know.
Two count.
Woo! Close, fans, close. Body slammed. No, backbreaker. Right on top again. Two.
He's got hook in the leg. He's giving Bob a chance to slip out the back door. Can't understand it.
Well, Slaughter's just very, very tired.
Another backbreaker.
Look,
he's not hooking that. Look, he's slipping right out the back door, Dick.
You got it.
He's not hooking that leg.
Two.
Maybe he's looking for that Cobra clutch. Who knows? Nice reversal by Backlund. Sunset flip here by the Sarge. Could be a title. Oh.
He brought both heels down.
Desperation move on the part of Backlund.
For sure, brought both heels down to the top of the head of Slaughter, and that broke it.
Slaughter outside the ring now, looking to climb the turnbuckle. I don't know where he's going. He's not even all together right at this
Backlund
moment.
Backlund was close. Wait a minute. Oh, wait a minute. He's in trouble. Slaughter knows it.
There's no place for Slaughter to go here,
no
but
place.
Up and down.
No place to
go. Holy mackerel, what a slam.
Count at 1, 2, count of 3. Backlund,
Backlund still dazed. Boy, he took some punishment in there.
We're trying to get him on the sun. Oh, the headbutt. Slaughter had enough sense to do the headbutt on Backlund.
Smart maneuver by the Sarge. Reached up, hooked both of those arms under that top rope, let that head fly back, and Bob was right there. He's looking for the Cobra clutch right now, Dick. He didn't get it.
He slipped out, kicked out. Slaughter outside the ring, falls to the concrete floor. Man alive. I'm going to need a week to recuperate from this.
Batman came that close to having that Cobra Clutch slapped on him, and it would have been good night. We would have had a title change here tonight.
Batman's not really with it much now.
He's got it on now. Unfortunately, he's outside the ring. Bob Backlund trying to fight, trying to get Slaughter. He's pulling Slaughter back in. The bell is rung. Referee Joe Morello trying to break this up. Slaughter may have been counted out here. We don't know yet.
I don't know.
But he's got that Cobra Clutch. He slapped it on. He thinks he's the victorious one. But I doubt it, because the Cobra Clutch was slapped on while Sergeant Slaughter was still on the ring apron. We'll have to get a clarification here. Slaughter grabbing the title belt, World Wrestling Federation title belt. Referee just now giving the result to ring announcer Mel Phillips. Let's see if we can get a clarification here.
11 minutes, 26 seconds. Sergeant Slaughter was counted out of the ring. Your winner and still World Wrestling Federation heavyweight champion, Bob Backlund.
And in frustration, Slaughter pounding on young Varela.
He slapped the Cobra Clutch on the referee. Backlund's right in there to try to help out as Slaughter bails out. And Backlund right after
him. He's going after him. You talk about crazy tonight.
Man in the ring now with a suit, with the red hair. Red Bastien, one of the greatest wrestlers of all time, making a surprise appearance here tonight. As Joe Morello needs help coming out of there.
He's holding his midsection. All right, we got a special announcement here.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, standing in the ring is a special guest. He is undoubtedly one of the world's greatest wrestlers, and we are privileged to have him here this evening. We would like for you to please give a warm Philadelphia welcome to Red Bastien.
Pound for pound, undoubtedly one of the greatest wrestlers of all time.
Well, there you have it. Let's check your screen now, see what just happened, if you have to be told. But if you want to watch it again, here we go. Backlund going to the ropes. Slaughter on top now on the ring apron.
Slaughter from the outside here slapped on that Cobra Clutch, Dick, but he was outside the ring. Now,
clearly,
it's only a five count out there. He could have counted to 15. Now, look at Backlund with enough strength left to drag him back over that top rope. But still, the count remained at only five. He was counted outside. And that was it.
Well, that's the story of that. Backlund being shaken by like a rag doll. Well, that's it, fans. All right, we'll be back with more. But Cal, let's check in with you.
A near-capacity Spectrum crowd went completely berserk. Here we are with Sergeant Slaughter. He has the World Wrestling Federation World Championship belt. I don't understand what happened. You hit the referee. He said that you were disqualified, counted outside of the ring. Tell us what happened.
Well, I was in the ring with Bob Backlund. I had the Cobra Clutch on Bob Backlund, your former champion, and I heard him give up. I heard him give up, and then I heard the bell ring, so I let go. The referee raised my hand. All the people out there, all the maggots, waited for 5.5 years for Sergeant Slaughter to show them. I do exactly what I want to do. I do exactly what I tell you I'm going to do. And I won the World Federation Championship from Bob Backlund just right here.
Okay, why did you hit the referee?
Because he changed the decision on me. But I'm going to the board. I'm going to the board. That's it.
Now,
I'm the Backlund new champion. Backlund
chased you out of the ring. He wanted his belt back. He was beside himself.
He wants a rematch is what he wants. He can't believe it himself. He gave up. I'm telling you, Kel, as sure as I'm standing, as sure as I'm Sergeant Slaughter, he gave up before the bell rang.
All right, back to ringside after this.
Oh, all right. Let's get the announcement here. Next matchup.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next attraction is a special tag team event. scheduled for one fall with a 30-minute time limit. Introducing first, the tag team combination consisting of, from Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing in. Ladies and gentlemen, the pride of the South, weighing 250 pounds, Don Pernoodle. And his tag team partner from Moscow, Russia, weighing 238 pounds, the former World Wrestling Federation champion, the Russian Bear, Ivan Koloff. And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents from Puerto Rico, having a total combined weight of 460 pounds, the Invaders.
Well, the Invaders are really meeting some formidable competition here tonight in the Spectrum against the Russian Bear, Ivan Koloff, and Don Carnoodle.
Well, these Invaders are something else. They help each other. They pull on one another to give themselves leverage. What? Hit the bell, says Dick Worley. And we'll hit a little bit of a mention here that the main event for World Championship Wrestling at the Zembo Bosque in Harrisburg on August the 19th at 8 p.m. will be Ivan Putski, Magnificent Morocco, Fuji, Strongbow, Tiger Lee, Gorilla, Samoan 3, and Israel Mattia, and a big tag team match, all coming to the Zembo Mosque Friday, August 19th at 8 p.m. in Harrisburg. Be there. All right, they're working on Ivan Koloff, and I'll tell you, tag made. One of the Invaders back in, tag made, comes in again. And they're just picking up the action on Koloff. Back in again. He's training. He's trying to tag Canoodle. No way right now. This may be Pilbara before it starts. The Invaders, I don't know which one's which. One is in, then the other's out.
Well, number two is in there now, Dick. Tried to take the Russian Bear over with a mare, but just wouldn't go.
Oh, he ducks under the slash. Whoa! Two!
Only got one leg hooked on that. Couldn't hold him.
He rolled right out of it. Arm drag takedown.
Tag was made, though.
Well, Canoodle joins in. Back vicious. Quicker. Oh, he is murdered. He loves his work. Loves the pound on a man. Circling his adversary. Whoa. Breaking the back again, hitting down the lower spine, jarring the entire spine. Woo. Tell you.
That'll make you wish you were home watching the TV.
My
dude.
God. All right, here comes Canoodle. Ran that back against the upraised knee of Koloff, is outside the ring. Here we go again. Jesus, man, these guys, ten different ways to beat you. They know them all. God, what strength. He's been carrying the Invader around for the past minute or so, it seems like.
Well, number one, all didn't waste any time getting in there to make
but
the
still
save.
But Canoodle tags Koloff. He's in now. Canoodle will bounce out.
What do you want?
Number two taking a vicious beating. Submission hold here as this backbreaker is very painful.
While Canoodle getting buzzed by the fans, Koloff really doing a number on the Invader. Dick Worley trying to figure out if there's any submission involved here. So far, no.
Well, he could have broken the hold on a number of occasions. He was using number two's mass to add some extra leverage there.
Takes that section right in the middle.
Boy, these Invaders are showing me something. They can take some punishment.
Yes, they can.
Bear hug now by the Russian Bear.
Could
one
do
of
it.
His patented maneuvers.
Could do it, maybe not. And the other Invader giving a shot to Koloff, who has enough together just to tag. Canoodle, he's in. brings him down on that knee again. One, two. The other invader coming in, kicking off Canoodle. The one shoulder was up anyway, so it wouldn't have been a pin unless, of course, Worley thought he saw a pin. Slammed the head against the upraised foot of Ivan Kolov.
Boy, number two is really taking a shellacking, and quite a credit to him to be able to take this kind of punishment and still be in there.
The elbow. Oh, he brought the elbow down. The invader rolled.
He didn't make it.
Almost made the tag. Back body drop. Down goes.
Oh, he hooked his leg as he went over the top trying to get to his corner of the
tag. Couldn't make it. Still couldn't make the tag. Slam him on top of the turnbuckle. Well, he got 2-on-1 right now. Whoa, comes that elbow.
Vicious. Still to come, George the Animal against the Polish power, Ivan Putski. A lot more wrestling yet to come, so don't go away.
You talk about getting your money's worth here at the Spectrum. You kidding? You've been with us from the start tonight. You know you got to be here next month. Oh, there's a kick.
There's a tag made now.
The Bader. Oh, slow back body drop. And a slash at Ivan Kolov.
Number one in there making things happen.
Another slash. Canoodle on Queer Street. Kick out and
nice drop kicks.
Woo! He is tough. Is he ready? All right, the other invader in now. Canoodle coming toward it. Took full blast. And that kick, that drop kick went awry because the invader smashed his head, back of his head down on the floor of the ring. Took the shoulder block. Both went down, stunned. Count of two, count of three. Worley still counts. Five, six, seven. The invader starting to get up. Kolov trying to help him down again. Side headlock by the invader on Canoodle. Canoodle raising him down.
Oh,
they
vicious.
Go.
Suplex.
On the count of one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Kolov delivers a kick. The invader in gets a kick in return from Kolov. Dick Worley wrestling him.
Uh-oh, what a maneuver there.
One, two, three.
Did you see that, Dick?
He did, he got him.
He pushed number two outside the bottom rope, slipped in there and hooked him. Wrong man in the ring, made the cover. Referee Dick Worley did not see it, made the count.
Worley, all he knows is what he saw. Said the man had him. What am I supposed to know, he said. All right, let's get Mel on the announcement.
The time of the fall, 6 minutes, 42 seconds. Your winners, the Invaders.
Talk about trickery.
It'd be a sleight of hand, I'll tell you. Really did it to him. Canoodle still doesn't know what day it is. He's really stunned. Grabbing for the top rope, trying to get up. He knows it's all over. No place to go but back to the dressing room. Kolov still disputing the entire decision. Canoodle says, come on, let's go. It's all over. All right, here we go. Check it out. The invader gets a shot from the midsection. Down he goes. Kolov with a kick to the other invader.
Look at this now, Dick. Look at this. Takes his partner, rolls him right out under the bottom rope. Now the illegal man is in the ring, reaches over, hooks his leg, Worley turns around down for the count.
And there you have
it.
Count three.
I love it.
Well, all right. We're going to have more in just a moment. Let's get on with it. Hit that bell.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, it now gives me great pleasure to inform you of the next All-Star Card of Wrestling coming here to the Philadelphia Spectrum. The date has been set for Saturday evening, September 24. Scheduled to appear here on Saturday evening, September 24, in individual competition will be Tony Garea. Also, ladies and gentlemen, making his very first appearance here in the Philadelphia Spectrum after a lengthy convalescence due to a serious automobile accident will be Eddie Gilbert. And ladies and gentlemen, in a contest that has already been signed, Tiger Chung Lee faces Italy's Salvatore Perlomo. Also, ladies and gentlemen, there will be a special four girls tag team event. And ladies and gentlemen, scheduled Saturday evening, September 24th, is a special six-man tag team event. And it is scheduled for the best two out of three falls, having on the one side, Afa, Sika, Samala, Samoans number 1, 2, and 3, their opponents, the Mexican sensation Tito Santana, the sensational Rocky Johnson, and their tag team partner, Jimmy Superfly Snuka. And ladies and gentlemen, also scheduled for Saturday evening, September 24th, will be a contest for the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion. As the current title holder, the Magnificent Morocco, faces Chief J. Strongbow. And ladies and gentlemen, in the main event, Saturday evening, September 24th, it will be a special return match, and it will be featured and fought in a no-holds-barred Texas death contest. The principals will be the challenger, Sergeant Slaughter, as he tries to take the World Wrestling Federation heavyweight crown from the current champion, Bob Backlund. Ladies and gentlemen, in addition to those bouts, there has been signed a special bonus attraction. In this contest, Big John Studd faces one-on-one against the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant. Ladies and gentlemen, this bout will be contested in a 15-foot-high steel cage.
Toughest match in all of professional wrestling, the steel cage match with the two behemoths in there, Andre and Big John Studd, September 24th. I don't believe it, Dick.
I'll tell you, Gorilla Monsoon, I keep getting surprised by our promoters all the time. It's really wild. You consider that these guys in themselves would be a tremendous asset to any promoter, but inside a steel cage, I can't believe it.
Well, it's got to be the toughest match in any form, any way, shape, or form. Toughest match in professional wrestling. These two individuals be locked inside that 15-foot-high steel cage. It's just going to be unbelievable, Big.
Well, I don't believe what I see now, because inside the ring, there is the animal. And some of the fans at ringside are sporting...
Feed the animal, it says, Nick.
And some of the fans are sporting green tongues, too.
We're waiting for the Polish power.
Well, when he comes, the roof will come right off the top of the Spectrum. One more reminder, those of you in the Harrisburg area, Friday, August 19th, Zimbo Moss, professional wrestling, among other things, Putski and Morocco. Be there. Well, what a card for September 24th here at the Spectrum.
Holy mackerel.
Oh, holy smoke. Here he comes. The crowd ignited by the appearance of the beautifully tanned and very talented Ivan Putski.
Two titles at stake that night, Dick, on the 24th. Intercontinental title, Morocco putting it on the line, and of course, the big return match. Sergeant Slaughter left here with the championship belt here tonight. Whether he is going to be able to hold on to it is another ball game.
Well, they're talking about ball games. It's underway. Steele on top of Putski. Putski outside the ring, and down he goes.
The Animal, not sure what day of the week it is or what city he's in, I'm sure.
Don't know that he cares, but Putski knows he's in for it tonight. He kicks at him, smashes at him.
Uh-oh, foreign object now in the hand.
And very blatantly so, too.
Uh-oh, look at this.
yeah, right.
Dumb as a fox.
You're going to frisk that guy, Whirly? I don't know. Whew. Fans are on their feet, and I mean just about everybody.
I can't imagine why the hair grows everywhere but where it's supposed to, Dick, on his body.
Sure
enough. Putski in fantastic shape. Look at him.
Oh, great shape. Putski's still pointing to the now invisible object. He's been placed away. Now. Not wrapped tight.
The Animal making Whirly look a little foolish here.
Well, I'll tell you, Whirly doesn't particularly want to deal with the Animal, but he's got to. But Ivan very well willing to do battle.
September 27th, that big six-man tag coming our way, Dick. Samoans, 1, 2, and 3, Alpha, Sika, Samula against Santana, Johnson, and the Superfly.
You better believe it. Don't forget, that's on September 24th. Be here. Still, the Steel fooling around with that foreign object, and I think Putski's going to be on the short end, and he is.
Oh, he nailed him, Dick.
Right underneath
he
the
He caught
chip.
Him. Just a question of time until he nailed him with it.
Well, Putski's got to get that object, throw it away, I would think. Pepper gets himself together.
He got hit right in the windpipe with that.
He did. Steele knows he's in control. Steele indicating to all in attendance here tonight, including Whirly, he has nothing in his hand. And jabs Putski again with a foreign object.
Fans on their feet getting a little irate now at this point. Everyone in the building, the 17,000 plus here in the Spectrum, everyone sees that object except the guy with the white shirt and
That's
the striped
it.
Pants.
Whoa!
Oh, he got nailed.
Now, Putski on a tear.
He's going for the hammer.
That got him. 1, 2, 3, that's it. Putski comes down again. Steele on another tear.
Oh, and that nailed referee Dick Whirly.
Putski better defend himself. He's hitting.
Putski's got the foreign object now.
He's doing it to Steele.
Steele over the top rope. He won't be back. Watch a chair.
Steele.
He got double crossed, it backfired on him.
He's disturbed, he's kicking all the chairs over as he goes. He just wants out of here, and I think everybody's relieved that Steele has split.
What a night of pro wrestling we've had here.
These Olympics. Well, We saw it off. Let's get the announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time of the fall, 3:05. Your winner of the match, Polish Power, Ivan Putski.
Putski victorious.
Well, there's the replay.
Take a look at what happened here. Took a side headlock, going to ram him in, but he got pushed off, and wow, he just inches away from hitting that steel post. Putski takes over, throws him in, hits the opposite rope, coming off with a big hammer, and nails him right on the throat, knocked the wind out of him, down for the cover. He got the three count.
Well, Putski was right in the perfect spot there to grab him, and he sure did. And fans, what more can we say?
Stay tuned September 24th. Oh, we've got some blockbusters coming your way.
If you liked it tonight, you're going to love it on the 24th. Good month to you. The month coming up. Look for you again. Grill 'em on soon. Dick Graham here. Take it easy. We'll see you.